When that's done, now we can turn off all the lights. What's left on? Ignition, so the key off, and then the red master off. It doesn't help that there's a master, and then they call an avionics master.
Yeah.
All right. So, actually, for a first flight in the 152, which is a lot touchier than 172, that was a really good first flight. So,
good.
I think you got a lot of the control issues down. You do have kind of feel. You put me in the vicinity of the runway, which is about where I expect without teaching you anything about landing.
Yeah.
So, and that's also kind of how I can gauge how a person's going to be on landing, is how responsive they are and how much they've developed a feel for the airplane. Because I try to develop that before I ever bring a person in the pattern. And then after we've been doing the pattern, we're going to start integrating more talking into it as well.
Okay.
But let's go ahead and get out of this thing, and then we will talk about, because you did your steep turns real well, and you got the grasp of headings and altitudes. So, and the thing is, you'll get better. It's just like anything else. It's like learning to ride a bike, except a bike can do a lot of other things. When I first started flying, when I saw it, the worst thing I hated was the radio. And I was at a towered airport too, but I was not nearly as busy at this one. Because today was slow, and it can be so much busier. Like, it was actually good too, because then you can actually hear what I'm saying today.
Yeah.
3, 2, 7, 1, 4, 6, 3, 2, 7, 1, 4, 6, 1. Play that one for your significant other. I'll be like, yeah, that sounds really, really perfect. I'm like, yeah, flying kind of is. It's a fucking world of trouble on the cover.
You have to fly all the time. It's stubbed on.
I don't know if that's
that was.